What's up, dude?
What up? About to go push some weights.
Just roll them around.
Yeah. New low yesterday, 200 pounds on the dot. That's 17 pounds down in 10 weeks. Eating whatever the fuck I want, whenever I want. We lost some light. I just hit my macros, because it works. But there's something we wanted to talk about. Fuck this light. Because it's something we've been seeing a lot lately. And it's when it's good to give advice and when it's not good to give advice in the gym. And on top of that, should you be the guy that's giving advice? Now, there's two sides to this. There's the person that's very highly qualified, highly experienced, been doing this for a long time, giving intricate, detailed advice to someone that's just starting out in the gym, to the point where all of it's gonna go over his head. He's not gonna retain any information. That's like me finding some kid that's just asking me what's good squat form, and I'm breaking down the biomechanics of the movement. It's not gonna work. He's not gonna retain any of that information. He's probably not gonna enjoy receiving that information. He's probably not gonna ask that question again. On the other hand, you have a bunch of bros in the gym that are trying to figure out how to do a certain movement, trying to figure out what kind of diet to do to cut some weight, trying to figure out the new fad, and you're spewing out what you read on bodybuilding.com or T Nation or Men's Health or Men's Fitness. And what a lot of this information you're getting is something with a good headline generated to get hits and shared on social media to bring traffic to their website. It's not actually good information. But because you don't know any better, and it's not your fault, not everybody is well versed in this regard, but you're helping to spread that nonsense by giving bad advice in the gym. So what you got to look at when you're giving advice, or even when someone asks you advice, is to think, do I know what I'm talking about? Am I qualified to talk about what I'm talking about? Could my information potentially injure or harm or set back the person I'm talking to?
Or prevent injuries and improve the person that you're giving advice to?
There's no shame. Even I know a lot. I've studied a lot. I've been doing this for a little while. And I still get asked questions where I sit there and I think, I don't know the answer to this question. And I'll tell somebody, I'll be like, I don't know the answer to that. They'll ask me, hey man, what's the difference in carbohydrate metabolism? Actually, you better have. They'll ask me, hey, can I eat carbs before I go to bed? My response is, yeah, of course you can. Just, you know, worry about hitting your numbers. Well, I read on so-and-so that protein synthesis is greatly increased with the addition of yada, yada, yada. And he starts saying shit. I don't know what he's talking about. I know he doesn't know what he's talking about. And that's when I stop and say, listen, dude, I don't think you know what you're talking about. I have no idea what you're talking about. I'm not going to sit here and bullshit with you to try to make up a theory on our own to make ourselves feel better. So you're better off going home and looking on some forums to try to figure that out yourself. Or if someone's saying, what do you think's more beneficial for overhead press? Should I do the suicide grip or should I put my thumb around it? And you say, from personal preference, I think the suicide grip, just holding my palm, would be better. Well, what injury preventative method should I use if I do this? I don't fucking know. That's what I would say. I have no idea. You gotta know when you can give it good advice, and you gotta know when you are not able to give advice. The other aspect of advice giving in the gym is unsolicited advice. I entertain everybody that wants to come up to me and give advice because I see how excited they are doing it. If someone wants to come up to me and say, hey man, listen, those 45-pound plates do different things than the other 45-pound plates because they're shaped different, I'm gonna entertain that idea because I'm kind of curious to what the fuck this guy's gotta say. Don't go up and start giving advice. Dude, fuck this defense. Don't go up and start giving advice to people because you just became a guru And just because you came across some hidden gem somewhere that you want to tell the world about, that doesn't give you the permission to go up and start giving random people advice in the gym. Now, sometimes you see someone that's gonna hurt themselves and you feel like you need to be Superman and go save them. And sometimes it's a good idea to say, hey, listen, I'm a trainer, I know what I'm talking about. The way I see you do it is not very advantageous to what you're trying to get, and you're probably gonna get hurt. Here's a better method to do it. And you would do that during their rest set, not stop them in the middle of their workout. On the other hand, if you see someone doing some cheat reps or something, it's not your place to go up there and tell them, hey bro, you should use full range of motion for better strength hypertrophy gains. Because that guy's probably gonna tell you to go fuck yourself, like I would.
Yeah, I mean, you don't know their fucking rep scheme and workout.
You don't know if he's on his last set of 20 rep shoulder press on the machine. Full range of motion is probably not gonna happen on 20 reps. It's just not gonna happen every time. That's just how it is. So the gist of this is to, when it comes to giving fitness advice or receiving it, is A, know if you're qualified, and or know if you, think about if you actually know what you're talking about and if it's actually gonna benefit him. If not, tell the person you don't know. B, don't spew advice that you just read out of a magazine right before you walked into the gym because you're all hyped up on pre-workout and wanted to try some 8-hour arm workout by Rich Piana. Don't be that person that wants to save everyone in the gym by telling them what's good and good, what's good form and what's not good form. Because 90% of the time, if they do listen to you, they're gonna ignore you anyways. And your best bet is to go in the gym and just do, focus on what you're doing, lift, and get out. Because you should have other things to do than to sit there and help people. If you wanna help people like that, become a trainer and get paid to do it. If not, just worry about yourself, your friends that are there, someone that asks you, you'll give something that you can talk about what you know, and move on. That's basically all I gotta say on advice giving in the gym, when or when not to, and if you should be that person.
Yep. Nerds
and Muscle Monster peanut butter, driving in the Washington State rain, trying to do a video with this light in my face. Man, life doesn't get any better.
It's living the life.
Except for that deltoid pump I'm about to get.
Deltoid pump.
Kill him.
Tell by your charm and your arm, but I'm the
got a big booty.
Yep. Go. Let's go. Let's go. Yeah, just go to failure, man. Yep. Yep. Yeah. One more, go. Let's see a poke.